guys. Go, go. They're loading. No, it's interesting because you get the absolute perfect day, and yet we catch the current. Sort of a game changer for the morning when we go north with that. So we'll go and find out.
Alright.
Bye. But I don't need to go there now.
No.
you've ticked off the bucket list here.
Yeah, well, it's...
In a much more fun, exciting way.
Yeah, I mean, it's funny. I mean, it sounds... Churchill does sound really... It does sound amazing, but it's different.
Like Disneyland.
Kind of like the suburban polar bear.
Yeah.
With a penguin on his shirt.
Yeah.
The penguin.
I love that. That was great.
Well, they don't have narwhals up here, huh?
No. No. I think that at one time they might have had, but mainly over in Greenland and Canada. I mean, I've been going to Greenland for a long time.
Wow.
But the people who be, but there's a, there are places on the Northeast Passage where the people,
they've
seen, we had our first Northwest Passage trip, came into a bay at Cambridge Bay or something like that, and they had the scientists there, and they said there were literally dozens of narwhals, and they were tagging them, and the messengers got everybody out there. Just having a look to see. Look, I think it will be okay up here.
Thank you.
like you came here in the fall, but you know, just a little breeze up around this bay, and it's just, you know, just a nice cruise. But today we're kind of hoping to go a little bit further than the island. It's just a dark, dark day. And there's a reason why we're paying attention to whether the ice jams up, and we are in it when it jams up. It actually happened a few years ago to one of the West team somewhere up around here. And they were actually in a bay, and a big field of ice came around the corner and trapped them in close to shore. And that was okay, because they were in deep enough water for the ship to break through and try and get them. But it was going to take time, and then a polar bear came down and got on the ice and started coming towards them.
Oh, yikes.
Walked back to the players, and it took a long time. It is something you have to pay attention to.
Wow.
In the end, the bear just got bored. Stop. Yeah, it wasn't, I don't think the bear, from the whole account, it didn't sound like that.
They can swim, they can so swim, they don't care.
It's like they don't really care whether we hold them or not.
So they just come out here looking for seal, and when it comes by, they just grab it.
Yeah. Yeah, Scott, I'd stay probably closer to the center of the channel as you get up here because it's packing in on the land side of it.
Copy that.
Thank you.
causes this change of the current so quickly?
Look at all the birds flooding with the flooding with the current.
Flooding with the current.
Oh, fight, fight.
Yeah, exactly.
could be. I mean, it could be like right in there. It could be old track on the slope.
Yeah.
Right in here.
Thank you.
just like. Sound of the engine scares you.
No? They're not, I mean, it's gotta be pretty close to them before they slide in the water. If they're in the water, they don't really care. The bearded seal, you gotta be very careful. If they're sitting on an ice block, then if they see you,
just slide off the ice.
Thank you.
the other night we saw females and calves. All the packed on the little ice floes.
Oh.
Yeah, they're all around us.
Oh yeah, okay.
Dozens and dozens. Those were females.
Yeah.
sediment or?
Yeah, just dirt. Yeah, from probably. It's sort of weird because it's on sea ice, which means it wasn't just like it was from glacier moraines.
Just go up from there.
Oh, where are we at? We're close, right on the waterline?
No, up on the hill.
Up on the hill, okay.
So there's a rock by itself. And let me see. At like 1 o'clock.
Okay. Is it the tracks in the snow?
Tracks in the snow. To the right of the little lone rock. Oh, so hard. I need. Let's see what else I got. Okay, so you see the one, kind of the brown rock.
The domey one.
Yeah, so there's the big dome.
Yeah.
And then do you see the patch of brown?
It's all rough.
Thank you.
big bird clips up north of us. We're going to be there to see y'all.
Thank you. head's poking up 9 o'clock right now.
Can you stand up?
Yeah. She's at the ice floor.
Yeah.
Beyond that.
Ah, yeah. This went under.
Straight up the channel.
Still the back is at the top of the water.
It's moving away from us. It's probably the same one we saw. Just diving.
Oh, yeah, big body. Look pretty big, and
yeah,
I can't really tell distance right now, so maybe it was closer and smaller.
I think they probably saw a water coming through. It didn't sound like they were. They don't hang around.
Someone went over there.
We didn't make it. Is that fog or snow?
That's snow. Yeah, it's really changed. Everything just stopped.
Yes. Let's go the change of the tides.
Yeah.
This was full of ice.
Okay.
Okay.
right on up to the water.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, these across here.
Maybe the babies.
Yeah.
Look they look like cubs, you can see. So if you've seen them the other day, you can just imagine.
You can see it. Yeah.
Ice cream, but then we also have something called an over.
trouble cheering and bouncing and singing, etc.
And the other thing that was really important in the truck was the thing that really made it, and that was the light. This one did it to the rest of the world, the light that really showing the final place of the light, really feeling how beautiful. And we stayed there for 24 hours, and we had a camera to try out. Black feathers, and at the end of every black feather is a blue dot. There's just one guy who sat there on a computer for 3 weeks, just one penguin putting blue dots on a blue feather. It's just like, just cannot believe. The film, so I got involved in it at the very beginning when it was acceptable. Oh, okay, so initially I went and worked with George Miller, who's a producer, and I worked on the story development. Just that he was running some ideas, because he'd seen the David Attenborough series, Life in the Trees, and he'd seen Emperor Penguin, and he just was so impressed by their courage and by the whole thing that he said, I have to do something with that. And his brother, Bill and I, were good friends. So in 1998-99, Bill came to Antarctica with the East End. Afterwards, they asked me to come in and just talk a little bit about the film and then just talk about locations that we might get information. And then we had a big writing seminar that I sat in on. And then I was in charge of all of it. Putting together the team here that I had to do all of the data gathering. So we did two expeditions, one of the Ross Sea and one of the Rocky. But this video Yeah, that's right.